We were talking about biogeochemical cycles. In previous class, we talk about the gaseous cycles and there are types like nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle and hydrological cycle and what are the sedimentary cycles. Now we will in detail we will talk about the sedimentary cycles. The main contents of my topics will be sedimentary cycles, which can be phosphorus cycle and sulfur cycle. What is the human impact on phosphorus cycle, acid rain and adverse effect of acid rain and sulfur cycle. First, phosphorus cycle. Phosphorus cycle means it is a biogeochemical cycle, nutrient cycle, in which phosphorus is transferred into different segments of environment like lithosphere, hydrosphere and different kind of living organisms, but it cannot transfer into the atmosphere because phosphorus is not found in gaseous form. It is a part of rocks, it is a part of mainly sediment portion, so it is not found in atmosphere. So this is the, we can say that it is the transfer of phosphorus into different kind of environmental segments except atmosphere. The main components, it is mainly present in nucleic acid like DNA and RNA. It is the main part of energy storing molecules like adenosine diphosphate and adenosine triphosphate, ADP and ATP. And it is main, bones and teeth are formed by the phosphorus. So it is the main uses of phosphorus. The main reservoir of phosphorus is rocks. It is mainly present in rocks in the layers. It can be divided into two cycles. One cycle is called as a small cycle and second is called as the global cycle. Phosphorus cycle is the slowest cycle because it takes a long time to complete it. Now we discuss about the cycle, phosphorus cycle. At first, phosphorus is present in the form of phosphate, which is the nutrient for the growth of plants. When it is present in soil, this phosphate is consumed by the plants. First, we are discuss about the small cycle. Phosphate is consumed by the producers, which are plants, which is, it is the main nutrient portion part of the growth of plants. Then this is transferred to the animals, or we can say consumers. And by the decomposers, it decomposes into the again soil. This is the small cycle of phosphorus cycle. In this process, phosphorus is not added with any other element. But in other case, in the area of coastal regions and ocean related regions, sometimes phosphate is added with aluminium, copper or iron elements. And in coastal region, it makes some layers. After some time, such layers are converted into rocks, sedimentary rocks. And these rocks are, due to geological uplifting, they break down. Geological uplifting, we can say it is due to volcanic eruption. Due to earthquakes, tsunami, or we can say the weathering, in which the rocks can be break down in different kind of small molecules. And again, phosphorus is found in the soil and aluminium, copper, ferrous are break by the phosphate. This is the global cycle of phosphorus. It takes long time to complete it, so it is also called, it is the slowest cycle in all the cycles. Now what are the human impact on phosphorus? Eutrophication occur. Eutrophication occurs due to the high level of phosphorus in water molecules, water levels, because sometimes it is also used as a fertilizer or insecticides. When plants do not absorb all the phosphorus due to rainfall and heavy wind, Phosphorus is transferred to the ocean, rivers and ponds and other water resources, and at that time there is the growth of nutrients in that water resources. So this makes eutrophication process, and that area is made dead zone due to the lack of oxygen, because there is the presence of a huge amount of algae, and they make a bloom of algae, and that due to high nutrients there is the low level of oxygen. Level of oxygen will decrease, and it is adverse effect on fishes and other aquatic plants. So that problem is called as the eutrophication, which is not useful for the aquatic life. Some health related problems are occur due to phosphorus. Immune system will damage, and skin cancer are also done by the high amount of phosphorus in body. Now second sediment cycle is called as sulfur cycle. It is not proper sedimentary cycle because atmosphere are also included in such type of cycle. In natural form, sulfur is present in the form of solid. It is the 10th most abundant element present on environment. It is mainly present in amino acids, proteins, vitamins and enzymes, and its main reservoir is rocks, and it is also found in oceans as well. In sulfur cycle, due to volcanoes, rocks can break, and there is some gases are released from the rocks like sulfur dioxide and hydrogen sulfide. Hydrogen sulfide can also come from the soil by some sulfur containing bacteria. From oceans, there is a gas released, dimethyl sulfide, then sulfur dioxide, then this dimethyl sulfide is added with oxygen and it makes sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide are also released by the automobiles and due to vehicles and factories. Then the sulfur dioxide, which when react with oxygen, it makes sulfur trioxide. It reacts with oxygen molecules and it makes sulfur trioxide. Then this sulfur trioxide can be react by the water, or it can react by ammonia. When it react with water, it makes sulfuric acid, and when with sulfur trioxide react with ammonia, it convert into ammonium sulfate. All these are factors are responsible for the acid rain. They make acid deposition to the earth by the rain, and these acids, these sulfate ions, sulfate salts come to the earth, and these are consumed by the plants, and they are made into the soil as the sulfate salts. Plants consume, animals consume the plants, then by the deposition decaying matter it converted into the hydrogen sulfide. These hydrogen sulfide is again transferred to the atmosphere by sulfur containing bacteria. Sometimes due to anaerobic bacteria and chemobacteria, hydrogen sulfide is converted into sulfur, and again sulfur is converted into sulfate ion in the presence of some aerobic bacteria. So this whole cycle goes on, and this is the example of sulfur cycle. In sulfur cycle, we talk about how H2SO4 form. This is the main cause of acid rain, because in acid rain, the pH of rain is about 3 or 4. Mainly, the rainwater is slightly acidic. The pH of simple rain is about 5.6 to 5.7, which is measured by pH scale. pH scale is a scale in which if pH is about 1 to 6, the liquid will be in acidic form. If pH is exact 7, it will be in neutral form. And when pH is 8 to 14, it will be basic form. It will be base. So in acid rain, the water of rain is mainly highly acidic, and it deposits to the earth. The main responsible gases for acid rain are SO2, sulfur dioxide, and NO2. Both these gases are the responsible for the acid rain. Acid rain was first given, the main concept of acid rain was given by Robert Angus in 1872. And it was first seen in Manchester, England. In acid rain, we can say सिंपली वी कैन से दैट ड्यू टू ऑटोमोबाइल्स, ड्यू टू एयर पॉल्यूटेंट्स लाइक ड्यू टू वॉल्केनिक इरप्शंस, ऑटोमोबाइल फैक्ट्रीज एंड ड्यू टू पावर प्लांट्स, देयर इज अ रिलीज ऑफ सच सम पॉल्यूटेंट गैस लाइक SO2 एंड NO2 इन अवर एटमोसफियर. दीज SO2 एंड NO2 प्रेजेंट इन अवर एटमोसफियर एंड वैन रेनफॉल इज अकर, दीज SO2 एंड NO2 रिएक्ट विद द H2O मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ वॉटर. When they are combined with H2O, SO2 is combined with H2O and NO2 is combined with H2O, it makes two types of acids. First is H2SO4 sulfuric acid and second is HNO3 nitric acid, which are responsible for acid rain. So the reaction is as follow: 2SO2 gaseous form plus O2 plus 2H2, it make H2SO4 sulfuric acid, and in other hand, and 4NO2 plus O2 plus 2H2O, it gives nitric acid. Those are which are contribute to in acid rain. The main effects of acid rain and sulfur are as follows: it can disturb the blood circulation process, eye related problems, eye irritation can cause, reproductive failure can cause, it damages our immune system and damage of liver and kidney functions, and many buildings and monuments are also damaged by acid rain, and it is also called as stone cancer. In next class we will talk about ecological succession. Thank you.